Greetings once again. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. My discussion topic for today is once again, why semi-trucks now? And the Elon Musk answer and then my answer to that. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Bonjour, wie geht's? Wie steht's noch immer aus Freibahnen? Ni hao ma, zdravstvuyte. My topic today focuses on why semi-trucks now. And I found it interesting because the first time I made this video, maybe a month ago, you know, there's been sort of new data that's come in, and the biggest is that Elon Musk pointed out that he felt that right now was a good time because even before delivery of the Model Y, his feeling was that the trucks, namely the big Class 8, 80,000 pounds of cargo trucks, generate way more pollution than the Model Y equivalent might. And therefore, he's more inclined to get it to market before the others. I think this makes sense. I also think there are other things affecting that decision. One of those things is the 2170 battery. It's just arriving first week of July 2017 in the form of the Model 3. There's going to be an opportunity for a lot of people to study the battery pack carefully and see what the performance factors are on this new battery. But as I shared earlier, I think the biggest performance factor is that it's a lighter product that carries, that has more power and is cheaper to produce. So as a result, it allows a longer distance run for trucks hunting for a 500 mile of distance before that truck has to pull over and recharge or change tractors. I think that, this has been shared by many people that if he can achieve that 500 mile range and have enough cargo to make it economical for big firms to do this, all the form factors that probably represent a 50% cut in costs for truck folks is going to result in an avalanche of business to Tesla. Elon Musk's comment also included the fact that there was unlimited demand by current customers for the semi product. I can agree in terms of what I've read, because there's unlimited demand for the light duty trucks. The medium duties are being tested right now, and I haven't been able to figure out where he's testing these semis. But as I shared, in an industry where a 5 or 7% price difference can make it all the difference in terms of what manufacturers or shippers or companies are doing, and to offer a 50% plus cost cut, is huge and generates huge numbers of new customers for that product. Another truck development, and I have to give these points to Seeking Alpha, is that there's a suggestion that it might make more sense to swap tractors and then let the tractor charge for 6 to 8 hours rather than to try to supercharge a tractor. But I think that'll all be explained in September when Elon Musk delivers. In general, though, another sort of variable that I covered earlier is something called first mover advantage. And that means that right now Tesla is in somewhat of a race with other companies, be it Nikola with their hydrogen range extender, or there are other companies that are doing electric buses, or a turbine combined with electric batteries, to provide garbage trucks, for example. So there's a lot of competition out there that's lining up to control customers into the future, and there's a real need for Tesla to get a truck product out there, and then customers sort of in nearby markets to that semi product will have to sort of look at the competition before they go with maybe the one solution that's available currently. So I believe that this is, I think it's big, because I think if there was enough battery capacity right now and there was 500 mile capability, Tesla would completely own the marketplace. Another issue that I had raised was Tesla trying to find, you know, a large, well-heeled client like a FedEx, for example, as a way to drive the business. That was wrong on my part because, if anything, I think there's going to be a bidding war among the largest buyers of trucks to see who can pay more in the form of early payments or other activities to control early access to battery supply, because I think that competitive advantage that you gain by having this truck product early is going to allow you possibly to put competitors out of business, but definitely to generate profits early. You know, another subtext to this whole thing, and I'll be doing another video on this, is what's the story with the Mercedes-Benz Tesla relationship? Many of my viewers have been asking questions about how is it that I figured out that Mercedes and Tesla are working together. The first element of this was that Elon Musk actually announced that they're building battery packs for Mercedes. The initial look was that the Minigram product that Mercedes-Benz has put out. But I'd like to invite those interested in trucks to Google 1 hour charging Fuso, Mitsubishi, and Mercedes. And what this is about is that there's Mitsubishi is 89% owned, the trucking part at least is 89% owned by the folks at Mercedes-Benz. If you look at the information online, you'll find that the Mercedes-Benz owners have been sort of testing and preparing electric trucks for quite a while, and they have 4 million Fusos around the world, and they have a Fuso line truck called an eCanter, which is a light-duty truck. This truck, you know, is like a 150 mile and under delivery truck. It may be 2 or 3 tons, I believe, is the max capacity. But you'll note that it does list, it has a backup 1 hour charging ability available if you choose to use that option versus an overnight, all night charging circumstance. And so I then looked at this 1 hour, if you will, supercharge ability. They did not list it as a supercharger, they just listed it as 1 hour charging, as a rapid charging as an option. The next stage is that one could go and look at the fact that there's only one company that does a charging situation with 1 hour, and that's Tesla. And you know, the next issue is that most of the competitors to date that are at scale are all delivering their battery situations in a pouch. So there was a decision made between, do you do a pouch, which is most of the competitors to Tesla, or do you do a metal outside jacket? Tesla chose the metal outside jacket, and the rest, my friends, was history. It turns out that the metal outside jacket was a great move because it provides for supercharging, and the other types do not. I want to thank you very much for taking time out to embrace our dialogue. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Au revoir, à tout à l'heure. Max gut. The other note I wanted to make is that questions posed by my viewers end up being excellent coverage items. So if you have anything that you'd like covered, you have not heard, please drop us a line. Thanks and have a good day. Bye.